Here's another question coming from one of our Twitter viewers. This is at Robin Whitegood. And she wants you to address the issue of those who've lost loved ones during the crisis, people who couldn't hold funerals or have other loved ones over. This is, I got to tell you, a question I got from a lot of people. You mentioned this earlier with the isolation, but you're talking about a time when people naturally want to get together. We have funerals for a reason. We gather to grieve and mourn. When you're dealing with that, when you're coping with the loss on top of everything else, what advice do you have for people who are, for now, the thousands of people here in America alone who are going through this?
That's right. There are thousands of people in New York alone and all across the country who are going through losing loved ones to COVID. And there are thousands more who are losing loved ones every day for all the reasons that people normally pass away. And I've actually been to a virtual funeral already, not someone from COVID, but a neighbor who lost a loved one. And I think using the same tools that we can use to connect with people for other reasons, we can use to help comfort those who mourn. You're right. A death is a time where we have events like funerals, wakes, etc., in order to bring together a support network and help support the grieving individual. So it's important to activate those processes in whatever way is possible. It's true that for funerals in many locations, you can't have a live funeral, or you can only have a very small number of people. So have a virtual wake, have a virtual memorial where a lot of people get together on the web, phone calls, etc. Again, the individual who has lost, but also the support network of that individual, should be reaching out to comfort and send messages. And then finally, we can anticipate that this will end. And I think thinking about and planning for a communal recognition of the loss is something that a lot of communities are already beginning to talk about and think about. And I think looking forward to that opportunity to share in person with someone, the grief is important. Finally, I would add one more thing, which is that there is a normal process of grief. And it's important to recognize that sometimes when that process becomes so overwhelming that you can't function, you find yourself completely unable to sleep, you lose your appetite, you're unable to reach out to the social supports around you. That's a time where you might want to seek additional help from a professional.